Well, did you hear about this one? Protesters are crying out, ban the box. Washington, D.C. could be the next city to prohibit companies and small businesses from having job applicants check a box on their job application if they have criminal records. Attorney Judy Albanese believes companies should be allowed to perform background checks like this, but Whitney Bowen disagrees.
Judy, what do you think?
I would argue that the employee has an absolute right as well as a duty to have a potential employee.
An employer has a right and a duty, right?
Right, to have the employee answer the question. Just because you check the box doesn't mean that the person won't get hired. Just by way of example, if you have a gentleman who's 25 years old, he's graduated college, he's passed his CPA exam, and he was arrested at the age of 18 for getting in a fight, that's most likely not relevant to his employment. However, you take the other extreme, and that would be a truck driver who's been convicted of vehicular manslaughter, and he's applying for a driving position. Well, that could be a danger to the public at large, and also
or a security guard who robbed a bank or something like that, or somebody who committed credit card fraud and they're dealing with credit cards. You know,
absolutely. The Equal Employment Opportunity Commission has recently updated its guidelines from 1990, and they indicate it's to be decided on a case-by-case basis, and they use three factors within which to determine.
We can't really go into that, but you're saying that basically
the guidelines are there's factors to consider.
Okay, all right. Next up, could Malaysia Airlines be held liable for yesterday's crash? According to data from an aviation firm, global flights are now avoiding Ukrainian airspace. This, as Malaysia's transport minister has had approved the route, saying it was safe. Judy, do you think Malaysia Airlines could be responsible for this?
I absolutely do. I believe that Malaysia Airlines and the Malaysian government are partially responsible for the death of 298 individuals.
Do you think they could be sued?
Yes, I do. They had prior notice of the turmoil and violence in that area. In 2014, the United States, the FAA, issued a no-fly zone because it was so dangerous.
Okay.
They had an obligation to protect their passengers, and they avoided that duty.
I hear what you're saying.
There were two Ukrainian military flights shot down within the past 2 days. These are civilians. They should be protecting their civilians.
Those were low-flying planes. Those were not planes that were flying at the altitude that this plane was flying at. Which,
it doesn't
again,
matter. You have an obligation to protect your passengers and your citizens.
Okay, we got to leave it there. Boy, you gals really mix it up. You're terrific.